Welcome back. Haven't played this game in a while. I did some dying off camera to try and get back into the gist of the game. And before we do Yharnam, I do want to go back to the Hunter's Dream. Sorry, packing my cigarettes. Might edit that out. But yeah, before we do Yharnam, I want to go and do, not the lecture building, I should go to Cainhurst, that's what I should do. Yeah, Cainhurst it is. Let's do Charnel Lane then. No. Yeah, let's just do Charnel Lane. Yeah, so. Last time on Dying Interlude. I haven't played this game in a while and I had to get used to the controls again. Like I said, I've been playing a lot of original Dark Souls, and I've been loving that game. But going from the different souls, they're just different enough that they can fuck you up. Yeah, just different enough that they can fuck you up seriously bad, but they're just enough the same that, you know, if you're good at one, you can pretty much be good at another one. But the enemy AI... just different enough that you can get seriously fucked up too. If you don't remember all the cool kind of shit. Let me make sure I do have the Cainhurst summons. Yep. So. We have the Cainhurst summons, and now we're going to go to one of the more hidden areas in the game. I like to go this way through it. I don't really care for coming through levels from behind all like that. Although I'm not gonna lie, it is a bit difficult with the whole no blood bios. But one thing I've always wondered throughout the duration of these games is why in the hell are these ladies so big? Seriously? I did not want a plunging attack. Alright, so I can't get Dark Souls 1 to do a plunging attack, and this one does it when I get 1 through 3. And there's so many less mechanics in Bloodborne, I can tell you that right now. It's hard keeping track of all the different mechanics, but Bloodborne does not have a lot of them. Which makes it kind of hard, but kind of easy at the same time. I forgot I did not have my pistol out. That was lovely. And the elevation difference thing still applies. Just in any Souls game, even if you get the parry to go for a visceral or a riposte, you will not get it if you have an elevation or a height difference. Well, now that she's taken care of. I forgot all about these Yharnam hunters. Dun dun dun. Parry times are so off. Parry times are so off in this game. Ooh, I like that sound effect, though. Oh, are you serious, though? At least the healing is way faster. But yeah, I've been playing a lot of Dark Souls, and I don't know, I'm a huge fan of these Souls games now, even though I never was until now. Which is kind of weird, but people should get it at the same time. Sorry, dogs, we're gonna ride the carriage. Craziest of the crazies. And that's something I never noticed before. You can actually see the church tower from all the way over here. That's pretty cool. I wonder if you can see Bergenworth then. Don't mind me. Sorry, I'm kind of taking in the view. Oh, that's pretty cool. But yes, we're in Cainhurst now, one of my alternately favorite and most hated places in this game. I hate the Bloodsucker Lickers. I hate them with a passion. I do not even fuck with them. Just because they fuck my day up. So, I'm going to show you the Ian way of taking care of this area. Pay attention. Even fuck with that courtyard at all. And then just the beauty of this place. This is an amazing castle. There are some ghosts here, but luckily you don't have to be transient cursed to hit them. Yeah, this is like, I love the architecture of this castle and whatnot, but I hate the courtyard. The actual level design of the castle is one of my favorites. But I do not care for any of the courtyard crazes, as it were. See, that's another difference. In Bloodborne, you have to get used to playing without lock on, but because there's so many enemies at once, the other Souls games, you can actually play with lock on because you have a shield and you're able to defend yourself. Rider Palash, another weapon I've never used. And see, I like taking care of these ghosts because they're just like free soul echoes. Or not soul echoes, blood echoes. Because they're actually not too hard. But see, perfect example. In Dark Souls 1, you can get the jagged ghost blade. Tell me these ghost blades would not be cool. And that's what I mean by, I wish there was a little bit more, weapons in Bloodborne. Like, I wish it was kind of more like a Souls game, where you could actually get the enemy's weapons in here. Backstep. Don't mind me, I'm just kind of having fun killing. I just love the atmosphere of this castle. I just think it's amazing. The architecture. Just everything about this castle I love. Except for the fact that ghosts sound like stone when you smack them. Lots of you ladies. Echoes any day. Bye. Yay, more bloodstone chunks. Now we can come over here. And the regain system. That's another system that I didn't realize how much I got used to when I went to play Dark Souls 1. Because Bloodborne's the only game that there's regain in. Nope. You ain't attacking me, lady. Sorry, I'm just kind of having fun playing the game again. Don't mind me if I don't talk too much. Get some bullets. Oh. Nope. shoot him. Yeah. I didn't realize that the first swing of the 9 transformers was actually slower. Look at the 9. Just this atmosphere and architecture of this room. I just think it's amazing. I love it. Yep, you're dead too. I'm not gonna worry about that lady over there. But you, I will worry about. Noble dress. What do I want with a noble dress? Actually, the noble dress is the confirmation that Ariana is a Cainhurst noble and not just a whore, literally. And now this leads us out to here. Can you spot what's not like the others? Poison. Another one just came around here somewhere. Oh, there he is. Yeah, you're done, bud. Twin Bloodstone Shards. Sweet. But yeah, man. Just kind of enjoying the game, going through Cainhurst right now. Loving the atmosphere of the castle. The castly castle place. And y'all wanna see something fun? Bye! Dumbass. Did he just die? Where did he go? I guess he fell all the way down there and died. This view is just amazing. You can see where we came in at right there. There's the bridge. Just the city of Yharnam over there. You know, just having a little fun. Oh no! I forgot there was another one. That's weird. I never noticed the gargoyles had hair and beards. That's pretty cool. That is pretty cool. Sorry, I'm playing real close to the TV today and, noticing a lot of things I've never noticed before. Oh, homeboy up here. Forgot about homeboy. I believe that was a Cainhurst knight. All kinds of Nike statues. Over here, there's two homies just chilling. And you can actually hear a lady crying here. I never realized that. Push him over the edge. Oh no. No. What do you think you're doing? What do you think you're doing coming after me like that? No. You don't get up. Stay down. Bad gargoyle, stay down. The executioner garb, which I personally have never really been a fan of. I think it looks too big and bulky for me. Now we come to a fun room. Dun dun dun. The vile blood register. That's for online play, so I don't worry too much about that. This is the shortcut to the courtyard downstairs. Now that we open that up, we can come back in here and kill these chicks. It's not really necessary to kill these chicks. You can run through these rooms real fast. I just feel like having some fun. I kind of want to use the saw spear now. I just like killing these ladies because it's free blood echoes. God dang it. Every time I say free blood echoes, I get hit. Alright, I think it's about enough with this. I think I'm just gonna continue the level. Grab the Evelyn right here. And this guy, Mr. Darts Aplenty. Mr. Darts Aplenty will smack you with a dart, and then all the ghosts chase you. It's like a tracking device. But as soon as you run out of there, you're good. Oh! Oh, bud. And then you got a guy, he's shooting blow darts from over here. This is such a huge archive of books and whatnot. Ow! Freaking cane holder guy. Oh, cane holder Cainhurst, I get it! Cane holder Cainhurst, get it? Ha ha ha! I forgot how much freaking fun this game was. Nope. Sorry, bud. That's the bucket for you. Oh. Nope. You can actually see that ladder right there too, which is pretty cool. From the bookcase. Come on, come over here, bud. I forgot, no shield. Oh my god, I hate these guys. Annoying little guys. That's what they are. They're annoying. That's what they are. Meh. Just kind of running around, knocking over books, not giving a shit about Cainhurst. Oh. Oh, whoops. No, 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 no. Yeah, how do you like that? Wrecking tables and shit. And I believe that's all for up here. There's just a bunch of enemies. You can actually run straight through all those enemies to come over here and go out that door, because that's actually the way forward through the level. Just making sure I didn't miss anything. No, I didn't. Big jump. Now we come out here. Yeah. It's kind of crazy how this is the way forward through the level. More quicksilvers. Oh, here he comes, too. Johnny the Gargoyle. How you take care of them gargoyles. And then this is actually the way forward through the level, but once we get there we can't go back, so I do want to go in here. Nope. Slice Ghostbustin in the back when they're not looking, because I'm an asshole. I'm an asshole. No, you ain't screaming at me. Get away. Oh, forgot about that. Let me go, let me go, let me go, let me go, let me go. Yeah, I know, you like to run this way. That's exactly what I wanted to do. You fell into my trap. Ha ha ha. Come on, screamer. And this is actually one of my favorite places for farming echoes. If you're having trouble and you need to level up even a little bit, I actually like to go to Cainhurst and kill all these ladies. Because as you can see, farming pretty good. We didn't even do the courtyard, and we already have almost 50,000 echoes. This fucking douchebag right here with his goddamn fucking. Oh, you. Always screaming. Here, baby. Right over here is where we get the executioner's glove. That's another arcane item for summoning. But me being not too privy on summoning and arcaneness, I haven't really made an arcane character. Maybe that's what I should do. And the knight's garb. It's actually pretty cool looking, but I like my garb right now. And this is kind of pretty cool. You, like, don't know where to go. And then you're like, no, this can't be right. Oh, yes, it is. The platforming sections of this game are just crazy. Because you're like, nah, that can't be right. Get down here. Yeah. Silly gargoyle. And I like how Cainhurst is in the middle of the Moonside Lake. if you didn't notice. I think that's pretty cool. And now into here, where we pull this lever. And now look where we are, back in the very beginning. Or we can go up this ladder. Look over here. And that is where we saw that ladder from the opposite side. So now we can come up here, and this is actually how you get to the boss of the level. Which I am not a fan of, Martello Garius. He gave me quite a bit of trouble on my first playthrough. I was extremely salty over Martello Garius for the longest time. Just want to make sure I didn't miss anything. I didn't think there was anything up here other than a wandering madness. We got some chunks out of him. That's a good thing. Yeah, I didn't think there was anything else up here. But, you know, it never hurts to double check. Get out of my way, chairs. And you come up here, it leads you to some more rooftops. Where the snow crunches beneath your feet. Red gargoyles, red eye gargoyles. Yeah, red eye gargoyles are a little bit harder. Toast. Cutting up some gargoyles up on the rooftops. Getting a nice wig on the rooftops. And you come over here, you drop down right here. You drop down right here. You get a nice pretty little view before you drop down again. And you drop down again. And this is actually the boss of the level, Martello Garius. Which I don't think I'm going to fight right now, since this is actually at a half an hour. And I don't know if I'm going to live or die in the fight. And I don't really want to die right now. Not with these blood echoes. Which is why they give you the bold hunter's marks. Because there's no way out from up here, as far as I know. Look at me, all bloody and nasty. Yeah, so we're gonna bold hunter's mark back to the dream, and then next time we will come through and we will take care of Martello Garius. Returning to the hunter's dream. Alrighty. Yeah. We will take care of Martello Garius next time while I just kinda bug out right here. But no, seriously, we'll take care of Martello Garius next time, and thank you for watching.